This unit is the Crocodile tail loop, the OC10. This is the biggest loop switcher that we do in the range, and it is a very popular unit among artists, musicians around the world. So I'm going to show you the back of the unit first and try and take you through an explanation of how it works. So sort of give you some ideas for anybody who's looking to get into you know, something where you're switching a lot of effects. This will do 10 effects at once if you need that. I know there's guys out there with loads of effects on board, so this is a fantastic unit for that scenario. And when you look at the price comparative to, say, other things that are out there, and the quality, it is superb value for money. So around the back of the unit, I'm going to show you first what we've got on here. It's probably going to look sort of like, wow, this is crazy, but it is, once you get used to it, it's pretty straightforward. So I'm going to come from the left hand side. So over on the left hand side, this is the first and only unit we do with MIDI. So MIDI in, MIDI out. It runs 70 patches on MIDI, running a single channel on MIDI. We've also got a switch here for MIDI out, MIDI through, so if you were controlling it in the line with other MIDI units. Next over, we have the sync link function, which allows you to sync this unit up with another one, another RC10. So you can actually run two of them together. So you can run them, two of them in a scenario where, say, somebody is on stage and someone's off stage and they want to control the unit that's on stage via an offstage unit, so it'll work that way. But you can also use it to add an additional 10 loops. So you've actually got 20 loops and you can sync them together, so you could have 20 loop switching, which is a lot, but if you're in the Red Hot Chili Peppers, it's probably not a lot of pedals, so there you go. Next over, our standard 9-bot input. This runs about 350 milliamps, so it's a reasonable current draw, but it's not crazy, and I'll work with most of the standard power supplies out there, like the Voodoo Lab stuff. We've again got this buffer in here, like we have on the Camille, also the BGF buffer, in and out here. You don't have to use it, because you can actually go straight into the unit through the input here if you want to do. So you don't need to use the buffer if you don't want to do it. But if it'll help your signal quality if you're running long lengths of cables and things like that, then, you know, it's probably a good idea to use it. We've got a tuner out here, again, that separates the tuner from your whole setup. So ideally, as I like to run things like that, because then you don't get degradation of signal, which I think you do get with whatever anybody says about tuners. So the input to the first set of loops is here, and right next to it is an output, so that's very confusing. And let's just ignore the output for a moment, I'll come back to that. So the input runs into the first seven loops. So this is loop one, loop two, loop three, loop four, loop five, loop six, and loop seven. And these are all internally connected. By that I mean the loops don't need to be linked by an in and out cable to make the unit actually work. They are internally connected, unlike the further three loops we've got up here, which are not internally connected, but I'll come back to those later. So the out section here runs at the end of the first seven loops. It also has a parallel sort of brother up here as an out two. So out one and out two come at the end of these seven loops. The reason you've got two outs is because if you want to run back into the second set of loops up here, it's a lot easier to do it running it from here than running it from here and having to come back over here. The out two is ideally if you want to sort of run a sort of maybe a four cable method setup. So you're running stomp boxes in front and then coming out of here back to the amp, and then coming from the send from the effects loop back to this unit and coming in and then running some effects in the effects loop of the amp, and then running back to the amp to the return. With this, you've actually got much more in the second section, you've actually got much more ability to do other things. So you could actually just use one loop for your actual effects loop in the amp. So you could put a reverb unit in here and then run back to the amp to the return of the effects loop, and use the other two loops as switching loops for switching jacks, switching, you know, amp channel switching, anything like that, you know, functions like that. So it has a lot of options that you can run from here. So seven loops here, and then an additional three loops here, but like I said, these are not internally connected, so you've actually got an in, a send, a return, and an out. So you need to, if you want to run to the next loop, then you've got to connect these two together. What we have at Guitar, is the guys here have some setup sheets that I've done. So if you were buying an RC10 from these guys, they can send you all these PDF files, or they can print them off for you. So it shows you lots of different setups running the RC10, because it is a complex unit. But so we've tried to, you know, give people an easy route into it. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to plug it in down here. Now we've got the RC10 plugged in, I can take you through how easy it is to program the unit. One thing that I should say about the RC10 that differs from the other units is that it can be used in program mode, it can also be used in manual mode. So I hold down this button here, it switches it into manual mode, which now means that all these switches are accessed to the actual loops on the amp. So when you sort of bring them in, these are just bringing in the individual loops. So you can do it like you would do with a normal switching, but without programmability. Just holding that down, it switches it back to its normal program mode. This first button here, although it's loop 10, is actually a tune and mute as well. So you just kick that, it mutes the board straight away, takes it direct to that tuner output. So as in the Camellio unit, the loops are brought in by these buttons here. And so as you bring them in, so what we've got connected up here, in loop 1 I've got an exotic SL drive, which is a real nice pedal. Loop 2 we've got a Strymon Big Sky, again a superb sounding unit. So just bring the guitar up here, that's totally clean. There's loop 1 with the SL driving, and then loop 2 with the Big Sky. I'm now going to show you how to utilize one of the jacks as a switching jack on this Bogner amp here. So what I've done is I've connected this to the out of loop 10, which is the NO, which stands for normally open. And so now via loop 10 switch here, and if you see on the front of the amp, I'm actually switching from across here. You see that switching over. So rather than use this loop as a loop, I'm now using it as a switch. So that means I can then program that in to a patch. So if I want to make that change, for instance, as well as changing a stomp box and effect at the same time, I can do that. So what we're going to do quickly is set up a combination of patches so you can sort of hear what's actually going on. I'll see what's going on, I should say. So patch 1, we've got just the MIDI on here, so I'm just transmitting a MIDI patch change. Patch 2 has this SL drive in and also the MIDI. Patch 3, we're going to put in just the reverb, Big Sky reverb. Patch 4, we're going to put in this SL and the Big Sky. Patch 5, I'm going to put in the channel change so we can sort of hear that all happening. So firstly we're on patch 1. So we've just got the MIDI transmit there. Channel to the boost channel. on boost channel on the Bognor. So that's just giving a really sort of quick overview of what we can do in terms of nothing though, just transmit MIDI changes, a MIDI change and bring a pedal in, another pedal change, two pedals, and then a switch change to change an amp channel. So the same as we've got with the Chameleo. So program one here, I've got no lights on. So bank one, program one, no lights on. There's actually three on here, so I'm not going to be getting something because loop three is actually, there's nothing in it. But I'm just going to put it as loop one and then go on to actually the next patch to store that up. So I've just got the big sky, which is in loop two. So no loops, loop one, loop two. And then on the next patch over, I'm going to put in that one and that one together. So we're actually going to get, that was out there. So the SL drive and the big sky together. So as I've programmed these up, now the first one here is nothing, so it's just straight through. Second patch, SL drive. Third patch, big sky. Fourth patch, big sky and SL drive together. The other sections here, this one's to do with the linking. So if you're linking it to another board, it's a master switch or a link, so you can go into either of those. Again, this stores with the preset information as you would be doing it. The second one here is to do with the MIDI. So at any point, say for instance on patch one, say I want to transmit MIDI, I just press it on that, then it is now transmitting patch one, bank one, patch one. And this just goes up normal increments, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, all the way through. So if you actually run it with another unit, that's how it actually works. It's channel 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 patches. So there, it's not on. I can store it on with that one, and I might not want it on that one, so I'm going to take it off that one. So just see, we've got MIDI on there, MIDI on there, and then no MIDI on there if I don't want to change a patch. So very, very simple to actually program this unit. Again, probably one of the reasons it has been become popular with artists is because it's straightforward and easy to program. You're not having to go into complex menus and things like that, which make it really sort of, you know, difficult. With this unit, you can do it on the fly. You can pretty much do things very, very quickly. So, you know, it's a very, very good unit for the price. So everything that you've got included in here. So 10 loop switcher, 7 internally connected loops, 3 that are separated loops with in and outs. You've got a buffer in there, tuner out, MIDI facility, link facility. So, you know, really good.